convocation and induction ceremony. My name is Matthew Palmer, and it is my distinct privilege to have you here to celebrate the creation of this chapter and the incredible students who make it possible. The Science National Honor Society is a scientific nonprofit organization that engenders a new group of young thinkers who will be the future of industry, research, and scientific exploration for America. Established in 2000, founders wanted to formally recognize the students who excelled in science and committed themselves to furthering their schooling beyond the average student. They also wished to create a space where the scientifically inclined students could expand their knowledge and love for the discipline, past the boundaries of honors and AP courses. With these goals in mind, the Science National Honor Society was born. Today, there are 1,733 chapters all over the United States, fostering the young minds of future doctors, scientists, researchers, engineers, and so many more. It is our pleasure to have Londonderry High School added to this list. Now, without further ado, I'd like to welcome our guest speaker, Mr. Burgess, who is finishing his 37th year of teaching anatomy and physiology at LHS.
And it has been said that there
are a few obstacles that you're going to come across in your life that won't succumb to persistence. Consistent, sustained, intelligent, positive action. Another important aspect of science is to think outside of the box. Don't be limited in your thinking. One of my favorite stories to tell has always been of Alexander Fleming. After seeing many people die from infections after World War I, more people died from infections than from being shot. He and many other scientists started to experiment to find medications that could stop bacterial infections. One time he'd been out of his lab for a few days. When he came back, he had a petri dish with agar that he had inoculated with streptococci, and he looked at it and he had a fungus that was growing on it. So obviously he couldn't use that for any of his studies. Most people would have just disposed of it, but being inquisitive, he looked at it and he noticed that around the fungus there was a zone of inhibition. He figured there must be something that that fungus is producing that's preventing the bacteria from growing and killing off the bacteria that was there. So he tested it, pulled out a chemical, tested it on other bacteria, and found out that it killed a lot of different types of bacteria. That's how penicillin was discovered. And it also inspired lots of other scientists to also look at different antibiotics that could be used. Another aspect of successful science is collaboration. It has become much easier with the technology advances that we have today to collaborate. We now have scientists collaborating with other scientists on a daily, who are across the world. They're able to brainstorm, piggyback, and many of those advances come way quicker than what they would have come in the past. If Watson, Crick, and Franklin had worked together, they would have solved the structure of DNA much quicker. And then that huge explosion of molecular genetics, the Human Genome Project, sequencing genetic diseases, would have begun much sooner. And the genetic breakthroughs and treatments could have started much sooner. You are all entering an unprecedented time. With so many technological and medical advances, it is truly an exciting time. It has now been called the golden age of cancer treatment because of the knowledge we now have of human biology at the molecular and genetic level. Every tumor has a unique signature, and personalized therapies can be crafted for each patient using drugs that target specific markers on the cancer cells. Or now they can take your immune system and re-educate it so that it can attack the cancer cells with a new thing called CAR T-cell therapy. Radiation beams are now shaped so that they target just the tumor with very little exposure to the surrounding tissues. And there are now methods that are able to locally deliver chemotherapy. It'll be amazing to see the advances in the next few decades. There are still some negative public sentiments regarding science, however. Even with the ease with which we can find data, many people still rely on public opinion rather than data. They don't check the data, they don't check the sources to make sure if it's good science. Global climate change, COVID, renewable energy, cloning, genetic engineering. One of the things I've enjoyed about teaching the most is that science is ever adaptive. People used to believe that heliocentric theory of the universe. Copernicus and others found data to support the geocentric theory, which is what most people now believe. As better technology, telescopes, the Hubble telescope, and others were developed, new data was found to change what we believe to be true. When I started teaching, there were 17 known galaxies in the local group. Now there are 80, and we believe that there's more that are being included by the Milky Way itself. We've found planets around other stars, new species. We're planning on going to Mars. When they finally figure out what dark matter is, it'll probably change what we actually believe about the Big Bang. So my charge to those of you going into some field of science, being an inquisitive child.
Don't give up. Keep experimenting and trying to find solutions. Find a great team and collaborate. You'll discover so much more with others. Don't let the naysayers hold you back. Keep searching for solutions. Who knows? Maybe someone sitting here today will help find the cure for adenoid cystic carcinoma, or some other form of cancer, or another vital discovery. Congratulations on your induction to Londonderry's inaugural National Science Honor Society. And always remember, science rules.
Thank you all for coming tonight. So we want to get down to our induction. So I would like to induct Kathy Palmer first.
Londonderry's Honor Society. We are grateful for what has come together so far, and most importantly, excited for what will come. The upperclassmen before you today are truly the creme de la creme. I believe I can speak for all of us, saying we dedicated long nights of studying and understanding to exceed and become distinguished in our complex courses. It is my pleasure here to induct the seniors who have achieved this feat of scientific knowledge and insight, and to the juniors who have, as well, will join us for an adventure. Our adventure will consist of a combination of scholarship and service. We hope to pursue research opportunities with professors at UNH to give back to our members in the form of experience. And to give back to our scientific community at LHS, we will be tutoring students throughout the year using our knack of science. Of course, there will be more opportunities, and I'm eager for what's to come. Thank you. The Science National Honor Society was organized with the following objectives: to encourage and recognize scientific and intellectual thought, to advance students' knowledge of classical and modern science, to communicate with the scientific community, to aid the civic community with its comprehension of science, and to encourage students to participate in community service, and in turn, encourage a dedication to the pursuit of scientific knowledge that benefits all of mankind. The motto inscribed in Latin on the NHS shield, right here, translates, quote, "Fortune is one who understands the causes of things. It is indeed fortunate to have students like these here tonight who are willing to share their understanding of the causes of things with other students and community members."
Fuller.
Catherine Gregoire. Trevor Hayden. Greta Hayden. David Jarvis. Alicia Khalil. Austin Kilgore. Christian Leventowski. Sathvik Manam. Sage Master. Grace McDonough. Nolan McGovern. Cassidy Methon. Sean O'Mara. Madeline O'Shaughnessy. Aaron Orr. Emily Rivera. Isabel Shapiro. Abigail Whitley. And last but certainly not least, Dylan Risley. Thank you. Thank you and congratulations to you all.
Congratulations, everyone. Science is woven into the fabric of our society. It will aid students in understanding the causes of events of our world, from the macroscopic to the microscopic. Science is the tradition of Hippocrates, Newton, Pasteur, and Hawking have all followed. The Science National Honor Society will help culture new scientists who will also follow this discipline and improve our world. Our new Science National Honor Society members will use their science studies to better understand how the world around them works. The power of this scientific knowledge was illustrated with our color-changing reaction. Working together, the group was able to perform a simple neutralization. Everyone here today was able to provide a piece of the process that ultimately led to a successful result. My hope is that each member will continue to work together and apply their knowledge of science to help change the world. On behalf of Londonderry High School Science Department, I welcome you into the Science National Honor Society. Congratulations.
Spent countless studying Newton's second law at Bond Angles. 2 months later, we pitched our ideas to Mrs. Frazier and Mr. Terry Mill and asked them to be our chapter advisors. Both graciously accepted, and even more brainstorming proceeded. Fast forward to January, and Ryan, Mr. Cariello, Mrs. Frazier, Mr. Flynn, and I are sitting in Mr. Parent's office pitching up the society. One very stressful hour later, we walked out of Mr. Parent's office with a green light. The rest was history from there. Science GPAs were calculated, letters were sent out, creative answers to prompts were sent in, members were selected, and officers were voted upon. This night would not have been possible if it weren't for the support from Ryan, Mrs. Frazier, Mr. Cariello, and Mr. Flynn. To Mr. Flynn, I would like to thank you for your endless support throughout this whole process. You took the time to listen to two nerdy cross-country kids when you had much more pressing issues at hand. Ryan and I can't thank you enough for letting us start this chapter and all the creative freedoms that went along with it. Thank you. Thank you.